just an ordinary day in Manchester. Ian Brady and Myra Hindley drinking German wine. Their mother had gone to bed upstairs. She slept very well. They used to give her 3 second off every night with her cocoa. And Ian Brady put on his best clothes and his blue suede shoes, and he decided to go out with Myra Hindley, as it was 6 months and one of those special days. So Myra Hindley put on a dark wig and drove Ian Brady to the mainline station. And while she stayed in the car, Ian Brady went cruising on the platform. Same night, Edward Evans was also getting dressed in his best. And his mother, who didn't know that he was a little bit inclined to the young men, wished him well as he slicked his hair and put on his winkle pickers. And he went down to the mainline station. He waited for about an hour and he was beginning to think there wasn't going to be any trade that night. And then somebody came towards him wearing blue suede shoes, and it was Ian Brady. And he introduced himself. He said, "Hi, my name's Ian. I saw you down at the Viking last week." "Why don't you come back to my place and we can drink some German wine. I've got a car around the corner. My sister's there. She'll drive us back. It's only in Hyde. It's not too far. If it gets late, you can always stay the night." Dear Brady and Myra Hindley, very friendly. Ian Brady and Myra Hindley, very friendly. So Edward Evans and Ian Brady went to the car, and Myra Hindley drove them back to the little council house. Said hello to the dog when they went in the front door, and her mother was still asleep upstairs. And she made some excuses and switched on the TV set. And it was This Is Your Life with Eamon Andrews interviewing Sir Stanley Matthews. And she went in the kitchen, said she wanted to make some sandwiches for work tomorrow. And Ian Brady and Edward Evans sat on the sofa, and Ian Brady started to play with Edward Evans' fly. And he got a bottle, a couple of glasses, and right underneath the photograph of Myra Hindley's mother, they started to drinking German wine. And Myra Hindley went over up the road to see David Smith and Maureen Como, her sister. But David Smith didn't have a shirt on, and he was drinking tea with his wife. They had the TV set on too. It's all in a game. Sony information. And she said to David Smith, why don't you come back to our place, David? We got something rather special to show you. And he said, okay, let me just put on my jacket. And they both set off. Walking through the night. Walking through Hyde to their little house. One side of the house. Looking out onto the board, they knocked on the door. But he was used to that because Ian Brady had some funny habits. Ian Brady and Myra Hindley, very friendly. Myra Hindley, very friendly. And when he got inside the house, he heard some funny noises in the front room over Eamon Andrews' voice. And Myra Hindley said, why don't you go in there, David? You might like what you see. So he opened the door while Myra went into the kitchen to get some more German wine. When he went inside, he looked up at the sofa, and there was Ian Brady, chopping at Edward Evans' head with an axe. And he was chopping, and the axe was going into the back of his neck, and there was blood squirting over the Church of England prayer book. And a few drops landed on the TV screen and ran down Eamon Andrews' cheek, and some bits of bone and white brain landed on the hearth, just near the brass brush that they used to sweep the chimney. And there was lino on the floor, which was lucky. And it took quite a few hits before Edward Evans gargled. Ian Brady asked David Smith for some rope, which he had on a stick he used to play with his dog. And they put it round Edward Evans' neck and they pulled it tight until he strangled. And he made a strange noise. And then he died. And he was just a lump of stuff. Just a bit more information. Ian Brady and Myra Hindley, very, very friendly. Ian Brady and Myra Hindley. David Smith could, after helping wrap up the body in polythene and take it upstairs, he made excuses and left, very frightened, very friendly. And he went home to his wife, boring homo. And he told her what had happened, and they agreed that they just had to tell the police. But they were very frightened. So they stayed awake all night, holding one of the knives from the kitchen and hoping that Ian Brady wouldn't come around and say anything else. And then eventually it was morning. And they went out of the house at about 8 o'clock. Outside, into the street, they didn't know we're gonna meet it with Mrs. Bradley walking her dog, a little white poodle, and Mrs. Martin going to Lloyd's Bank to clean the waste paper basket. And they went quickly up the road till they got to the red telephone box. And when they got to the telephone box, David Smith gave Momo the knife and said, "You wait behind here while I ring them." And then he went inside the phone box and he dialed 9 9 9. The rather fat police sergeant, who was trying to finish checking his football tools, heard the phone ring, and he said, "Oh shit!" And he put down his mug of tea, which had a coronation picture of the Queen on it, and he picked up the phone. And when David Smith heard the policeman answer and say, "Yes, what do you want?" He told him and he said, "There's been a murder." "There's been a murder." "There's been a
murder.
the thumb. Your jacket with its friends. In my corner of this world, I see you walking, talking with your walking toward me with your eyeglass on my eye. Can't take it anymore. I reflect you. Look at your girlfriend. Her eyes. Her mind. Now take it. Let's head for. I get a cigarette. Duck down. The biscuit opportunity knocks. CIA walking in. Ultrasound. Last night I.
Only by your willingness to learn the rules of survival, well in advance of the peak, and civil defense helped you. Many Americans are overcome with feelings of despair, merely because they have built an insecure feeling since man made the atomic bomb. For what man has made to destroy.
At this time, Mr. Jack Porter, Civil Defense Coordinator for the Civil Defense.